of sick patients testing positive for a serious tick disease. Here to explain is Dr. Todd Ellerin, Chief of Infectious Diseases at South Shore Health. Always good to see you, Dr. Ellerin.
Hey, Dr. T, great to see you. So the disease is called babesiosis. And let's start at the very beginning. What can you tell us about the cases that you are seeing right now?
Right, so Eddie, this is caused by the deer tick that causes Lyme disease, but this is a parasite called babesiosis. Think of it like New England malaria. So the cases, first of all, I've been practicing for 20 years at South Shore Hospital. In the past 4 days, I've seen 5 cases. And these are very sick patients, very high fevers, aches, and they tend to have anemia. And what we find on the smear is that at least 2 of these patients have had close to 15% parasitemia. That means for every 100 cells, the parasites are in 15. And what these parasites do is sort of explode the red blood cells. The good news is that it's treatable, but a CDC study from about 3 months ago showed that babesia is increasing in about 10 states significantly, including Massachusetts. In fact, Massachusetts is the number 2 state in the country. This is something that we're going to see more of.
Number 2 state, wow. Yeah.
Okay. As you know, there are a lot of infections that can cause fever, fatigue, chills. How do you decide when to test for a tick-borne disease?
Yeah, Jessica, I'm glad you asked this because babesia can be funny, just like Lyme can as well. We generally think of it in summertime when patients have fevers. They often last at least a week or more. And they're not, you don't have that cough, sore throat, runny nose, and you don't necessarily have nausea, vomiting, or diarrhea. Again, you can have some of those symptoms, but basically, if you have unexplained fevers, you want to think about babesia and Lyme disease and other tick-borne illnesses.
And it makes me want to think about prevention, Dr. T. What is the best defense against ticks?
The most important part of this, because remember, babesiosis is traveling north. You want to wear long pants. You want to make sure that you use insect repellent. It's the same repellent that you use for mosquitoes. It often has DEET in it. 20% is what's recommended. You don't have to go higher than 30%. We have to repel these ticks. Babesia is on the rise.
And that's great advice, but when it's 100 degrees out and humidity is 100%, wearing long pants isn't really practical.
Right, so if you don't wear long pants, make sure that you're staying away from those tall grasses and the underbrush.
Great, Dr. T.
Good advice. Dr. Ellerin, thank you so much. Always good to see you.
Great to see you.
You too.
Have a great weekend.